Hi, everybody at the NIOA conference. You may not know me, but my name is Kerry Shearer. I'm a longtime former public information officer for the County of Sacramento. And in the last couple of years, I transitioned into doing social media consulting, web video and smartphone video production and training, and emergency communications training. And for that JIC-JIS EOC training, I work with Media Survival Group. What I wanted to do, because I know NIOA is so dedicated to best practices and exactly what's happening now, I wanted to bring you just a really quick video from the California Office of Emergency Services. That's where I'm standing right now. In fact, the State Operations Center is right behind me, and they're responding to Sunday's 6.1 earthquake. It occurred about 6.5 miles deep underground in California's beautiful Napa area. The community of Napa has had quite a bit of damage there and a number of injuries. Of course, it wasn't as bad as it could have been, but there was definitely some serious damage and some serious injuries in that community. But I wanted to bring you some information on how California uses social media in disaster response. And for that, I talked with Brad Alexander. He's communications chief here at OES. And then also Kelly Houston. He's deputy director for communications. Finding out a little bit about the use of social media, how they use it to reach out, and then also to monitor and gather information.
Right behind me, you can see over 100 people coordinating on this emergency in this building alone. We've got other facilities open and activated. There are people from state agencies, from the military, from federal agencies, from nonprofits like American Red Cross here coordinating resources to respond. I think that in today's day and age, we have to leverage social media as much as possible. I think that we've tweeted probably 30 times in the last few hours. We try to get social media messages out there as soon as possible, letting people know that we're aware of it. We know about how big it was or how bad the impacts could be at this point in time, even though it's early. I think we need to get out as much confirmed information as quickly as possible, as often as possible.
We use a lot of different tools in social media, and frankly, a lot of it we experiment with. So it's not necessarily that the way we're doing it is the tried and true way of doing it.
We like to use Twitter as for all those quick messages like that we need the public to know right now. If there's a longer message or something that might be closer to a press release, we might be using Facebook and WordPress.
So we use all of those platforms. So in the case of today, one of the things we want to do is provide the media with at least a glimpse of what's going on. And, you know, it's sort of reassuring to know, like, oh, we actually are in here doing something. So we have a camera that we can turn on and provide a live stream on Ustream of what's happening here. And then we push that out on social media like Twitter and say, hey, click here and you can see what's actually happening live in the State Operations Center. Skype's a great example of a tool that provides big dividends. And especially like in this case, we're here in Sacramento. We have the State Operations Center. There's lots of stuff going on behind us, right? But the media doesn't want to sit here and watch us working at computers. They want to be out in the field looking at where the building is collapsed, where there's water main breaks, where people are affected. That's 50, 60 miles away from here. So they have to make a decision. Are they going to be here or there? If we use Skype, that also provides them an opportunity to be here, but not physically be here. We can tell them, we're on Skype, we can do an interview with you. CNN does it, MSNBC does it, local stations do it. It provides just another channel of getting your message out in a convenient way, because the media can't always be everywhere, and especially today when the media, you know, markets are divided and there's less reporters than there ever has been.
Well, social media can be critical in a disaster. We can see potential impacts that we weren't aware of, road reports from just civilians on the ground driving around, possible building collapses in an earthquake that we weren't aware of, or it might be in a rural community.
There used to be the old days where you would say that if there was a photo published by a citizen or there was video put up, we would be very skeptical of it and frankly try to filter it out. We don't want to see it. Like, it's unverified information. But the reality is that drives the storyline of media. If you're not providing the images or providing context, those images and the things that are unverified are actually driving the storyline. Most of the time, it's a good gauge as to where you need to go for either rumor control or providing additional information, clarifying facts, focusing your effort on an area that perhaps you wouldn't have otherwise known, but because people are tweeting and providing information of something going on. So, you know, it's still an evolving medium for us.
We're not afraid to experiment. We're also not afraid to get out information as quick as we can. Sometimes we do trip, sometimes we do fall, but then we're quick to correct it. And we're open and transparent about the stuff that we're pushing out.
The sooner you get out there and at least establish the communication, essentially putting up the flag and saying we're here and we're looking into it, the better chance you have of being that source of information. Because the reality is, if you're not there, you're not present, somebody else is going to fill the void. And the times I've actually heard the most upset PIOs is when there has been this delay. They've waited 3 or 4 hours to get a press release out, and in that amount of time, some person who's taken opportunity from the public is using it as a platform to complain about how state government's slow or the local agencies are incompetent. And in that amount of time, if you would have just put up the flag and said, hey, we're here, we're obviously concerned about the people that are impacted and we're going to take some steps to help them, and we are, and we're going to provide you information over the course of time. I mean, that ends up paying big dividends when it comes to at least providing a channel of public information where other people can consume it.
I think that all the options that we use here at Cal OES or in emergency services may not be the right options for other agencies that are in other fields of communication, but I think that it's important to not be afraid to experiment, not be afraid to have some failures along the road, and if you aren't making mistakes, it's going to be much more difficult to learn something. You have to be able to trip and fall before you're able to run.
And that's my special update for the NIOA conference here from Sacramento, California. And by the way, this entire update was either shot or edited on the iPhone 5. So it's a great example of the kind of production you can do and the quality you can get from just using a smartphone.